You've also been a scholar of food. We're just going through the entirety of the human experience today on this humanities podcast. Another absurd question. Say this conversation is the last thing you ever do in your life. I, wearing the suit, would murder you at the end of the conversation. So this is your last day on Earth, but I would offer you a last meal. What would that meal contain? We can also travel to other parts of the world.
Well, we have to travel because
yeah,
my preferred last meal here, I probably had like two nights ago.
Which is what? Can you describe or no?
The best restaurant around here is called Mama Chang's. Mm-hmm. And it's in Fairfax, and it's food from Wuhan, actually.
Huh.
And they take pandemic safety seriously, in addition to the food being very good. But this is what I would do. I would fly to Hermosillo in northern Mexico, which has some of the best food in Mexico, but I sadly only had 2 days there. Mm-hmm. So somewhere like Oaxaca, Puebla, I think they have food just as good, or some people would say better, but I've spent a lot of time in those places.
So the scarcity, wait, is it possible the scarcity of time contributed to the richness of the experience?
Of course, but the point is that scarcity still holds.
Yeah.
So I want one more dose of the food from Hermosillo.
Can we describe what the food is?
It's the one kind of Mexican food that at least nominally is just like the Mexican food you get in the U.S. So there are burritos, there's fajitas.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't taste at all like our stuff. But again, nominally, it's the part of Mexican food that made it into the U.S., was then transformed.
Yes.
But it's in a way the most familiar. But for that reason, it's the most radical, because you have to rethink all these things you know. And they're way better in Hermosillo. Hardly any tourists go there. Like, there's nothing to see in Hermosillo.
Yes.
Nothing to do other than eat. It's not ruined by any outsiders. It's this longstanding tradition. Dirt cheap. And the thing to do there is just sweet talk a taxi driver into first taking you seriously and then trusting you enough to know that you trust him to bring you to the very best, like food stands.
So where's the magic of that nominally similar entity of the burrito? Where's the magic come from? What is it? Is it the taxi ride? Is it the whole experience? Or is there something actually in the food?
Well, you can break the food down part by part. So if you think of the beef there will be dry aged, just out in the air. In a way, the FDA here would never permit. Like, they dry age it till it turns green, but it is phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
The quality of the chilies. So here, there's only a small number of kinds of chilies you can get. In most parts of Mexico, there's quite a large number of chilies you can get. They're different, they're fresher, but it's just like a different thing, the chilies. The wheat used, so this is wheat territory, not corn territory, which is itself interesting. The wheat is more diverse and more complex. Here it's more homogenized, obviously cheaper, more efficient, but there it is better. Non-pasteurized cheeses are legal in all parts of Mexico, and they can be white and gooey and amazing in a way that here, again, it's just against the law.
Mm-hmm.
You could legalize them. The demand wouldn't be that great. There's a black market in these cheeses at Latino groceries around here, but you just can't get that much of it.
Mm-hmm.
So the cheese, the meat, the wheat, all different in significant ways. The chilies, I don't think the onions really matter much. Garlic, I don't know. I wouldn't put much stock in that. But that's a lot of the core food, and then it's cooked much better, and everything's super fresh. The food chain is not relying on refrigeration. And this is one thing Russia and U.S. have in common. We were early pioneers in food refrigeration, and that made a lot of our foods worse quite early.
Mm.
And it took us a long time to dig out of that. Because big countries, right? You've had an extensive rail system in Russia, USSR, a long time, which makes it easier to freeze and then ship.
What about the actual cooking, the chef? Is there an artistry to the simple? I hesitate to call the burrito simple, but...
And there's no brain drain out of cooking. So if you're in the United States and you're very talented, I'm not saying there aren't talented chefs. Of course there are. But there's so many other things to pull people away.
Yeah.
But in Mexico, there's so much talent going into food, as there is in China, which would be another candidate for last meal questions, or India.
India. Let's not even get started.
Unbelievable.